Well, hello there, humans, bees, earthlings, whoever you are, wherever you are, whatever you're doing, and if you're lucky enough indeed to be doing it too, welcome back to Channel 9 Bushcraft. Today, we are going to be talking about this little number here, the Yak Panther. This is the Tier 7 German TD that got buffed recently. I think it was patch 6.7. I'll just read the patch notes off for you here. The Yak Panther will now do all the damage. That's what the patch notes said. Officially, take it to the bank. That's what it said. And I'm going to show you some games and talk about the tank itself. A little bit about the history of the tank. Some interesting facts and stuff you might find to, be interesting. Well done, Bushka, once again, utilizing that private school education. The tank here is pretty phenomenal now. It's part of a line that has had many, many, many buffs. Both the J-Panther, the Jagdpanzer IV that comes before it, the Ferdinand, all the way through. They've done a lot of work on these Tier 7 German TDs. There was quite a period of time where they didn't really have a lot going for them. And then what they decided to do instead of completely reworking them was to just give them all the damage. And they are now absolutely nuts in terms of DPM. The Jagdpanzer IV has a... I'll tell you this. Like, this is a Tier 6 TD, right? The Jagdpanzer IV. And it has a whopping 3,266 DPM on its 8.8 centimeter Pachyl 56. That's crazy. That's a Tier 6 tank. But we're not talking about that. We're talking about the Tier 7 Jagdpanther, and it has a whopping... Well, it's got two guns, really, and this is the first thing I want to talk about, is the two-gun dilemma with this tank. You can run the 105mm Pachyl 52, the 10.5, and it will give you 2760 damage per minute. It will also give you 215mm of AP pen and 265mm of APCR pen. It has 8 degrees of gun depression, which is actually quite solid. And they've worked hard on making these tanks more mobile. The only nerf in recent times was they did nerf the traverse on the Jagdpanzer IV. It was crazy. It was like so twitchy at times. It was hard to actually use because it twitched so freaking hard. But this thing goes quick now, 55 kilometers an hour. It has 42 degrees of hull traverse, nearly 43 degrees of hull traverse. And its terrain crossing capacity, 99% for road, 84 for ground, and 68 for water. That's pretty good, actually. They're pretty good terrain resistance stats as well. What this tank does exceptionally well is damage. Its armor profile is not terrible. They buffed that quite a while ago now. But it's a tank that just spits huge, sweaty wads of damage out. Now, this is me using the high DPM gun, and you can see it just going... It's ridiculous. It's absolutely ridiculous. The high DPM gun, which is the Tier 7 gun, the Tier 8 gun, sorry, but it is a... Where are we? It is the 88mm Pach 43 L71. Now, that's 2,976 DPM. So, it has a slight DPM advantage on the Tier 8, about 200 DPM, which is about, I don't know, 4%, which isn't bad, actually. It's not bad. It's a good number, but its penetration is slightly lower and all that kind of thing. It does have the same gun depression and gun elevation numbers. Where the main difference is the way that DPM is delivered. This is with the higher DPM gun, okay? With the lower DPM gun, but the higher alpha gun. It's the rule of two. How long does it take you to fire two shots? Because if you can only fire one shot, then you want it to be a shot that contains as much alpha as possible. And the Jagdpanzer has a lovely blend of that kind of thought process with its 105mm gun. This will do 310 alpha, which is 90 more alpha than the 88. That doesn't sound like a lot, but at Tier 7, that is actually quite a considerable amount of damage. And what it means is that if you can only get one shot off, then this gun is going to be better for you. And in fact, as you go up the tiers, that quite often is the case. Unless you have some kind of crazy armor profile, that can really be a tough thing to do, to get more shots off. I don't know where that went, honest to God. I think it went underneath him. And it's also nice when you only have to clear one big chunk of health to have enough alpha to actually get you close enough to do it. The problem with that, obviously, is that it is not the highest DPM gun, which although it's a good thing, means your playstyle has to be centered around really spending a lot of time on target, and which probably means you do a lot more support. The gun's accuracy, and it is all about the gun here. Don't get me wrong. There's a lot of good stuff about the tank, but it is all about the gun. The gun's accuracy is also very, very important. It's 0.312 accuracy after all the bells and whistles have been added onto it, the 105 millimeter gun. But the 88 is 0.293. That 0.3 mark is pretty important. So it's a real balancing act. The thing that I'm happy to report is that both guns work exceptionally well. Both guns do exactly what you'd expect them to do, which is massive amounts of damage. Just huge amounts of damage. And I'm going to show you another game here where... This is not me. This is... Watch this. This is the truest opening sequence I have ever seen in any subscriber replay that's been sent in. Here we go. You ready for it? I'm best pet J Panther of EU. That's a promise. You know what? He's not wrong. If you watch the rest of this game, I think he makes a strong case. Oh, well. Gold Spammer from the North. And this is running the 105mm gun. The higher alpha, bigger alpha, bigger donk gun that has more pen. And that's a gun that... While it might not have the super fly ability of the lower end 88, it is definitely more versatile. It has more penetration, which means when you get upsized, you have the ability to go up to 265mm of pen on your APCR, which is really important if you have to face tier 8 targets. There's a lot of tanks like the IS series where you'll need to get over 200mm consistently. Even with variations to get the right kind of penetration numbers, like on an IS-3 Defender's frontal plate, you've got to be 200 plus. And being able to go to that really does help. If you run into any trouble, being able to go to the gold spam is a big thing. The other part about this tank that I particularly like is the playstyle is consistent. It's almost like the perfect dose, like from tier 7 to tier 8, tier 6 to tier 7 to tier 8. The Jag Panther 2, for instance, that you get into a tier 8, has a very, very consistent playstyle where you just want to show your upper deck and let the gun do the work. The Jag Panther 4, the JP you can see here, they all do the same thing. Something that I don't know if a lot of you realize this. If you look at this tank in real life, if you've ever gone to Bovington, the Tank Museum, I've met so many people at Bovington who all say the same thing when they see this tank, like, oh my God, it's enormous. In real life, this thing is absolutely freaking giant. You have no concept of just how big, how thick, how wide and how tall this thing is. I'm 6'5", and this is like, I'm putting my hand up to like at full stretch just about to get it on top of the tallest part of the roof of this tank. And the tortoise is the other one where people are just like, you have got to be kidding. This thing is a giant. KV-1 is another tank that is absolutely massive as well. When you see these tanks in real life, and Wargaming do a very good job of modeling their tanks, but I think this thing, it for some reason, its size doesn't show out. There's a tank like this, the Conqueror, for instance, is a very big tank when you actually look at it and put it up against some of the other tier 9 and 10 heavies. But we don't seem to realize that because the mouse is enormous, but this thing, legitimately massive even in real life. Now he's at 2100 damage already, and you can see the mobility on the tank is outstanding. It's getting across the terrain nicely. It's got great terrain resistance stats for the tough stuff. It's got gun depression. It's not hard to get the shots on. It's even like, we're saying this is the slow low damage gun, and you are still doing 2750 damage per minute. Like, That is a lot of damage with a 300 alpha gun. I can't overemphasize that. It makes it sound like you're getting the bad option, but it's got pen, it's got DPM, it's got gun depression, it's got mobility. It's just a great tank. And a lot of people don't play these tanks because the power creep at tier 7 and 8 now is just significant. There are so many phenomenal vehicles and they keep juggling. Like, all the tier 7 heavies seem to have been buffed to within an inch of their life. This is a lovely sequence of play coming up, by the way, the SU-152. Watch this excellent use of the gun depression and the angling to make the upper plate and then putting the gun mantlet into the guns, the SU-152's gun. So even though he goes to the heat round, I believe, he gets nothing but mantlet. Here we go. Watch this. This is great work. Gets, sneaks a shot in and then just bails straight down the hill. Now that's making his armor profile as high, but then holds just on the beautiful edge where it's gonna keep, there we are, and then jolts it forward. That's a great bit of driving. And something, if you're just learning your drive TDs, would not hurt you to have a look at. Look how fast the reload is on this thing. It's hilarious. He's gonna get there before the other guy. Bang. Nuts, absolutely nuts. And watch this poor old T29. You ready? The reload goes, the adrenaline is out, and the, so he's fired, one. Now he's just got to get a reload up. He's fired, and the Yag Panther is going to get two easy shots in before the reload's off on the T29. Now, that's 5,500 damage. The last guy is in a KV-1S with a stock gun. The KV-1 with a stock gun. I have no doubt that even if he'd been alive, this best J-Panther on EU, that's a promise, would have touched him up. And I am happy to show this, despite the fact that the last bit of damage is on a tank that has either given up or is AFK. Because if you're getting 5.5K in a tier 7 TD, I think you've earned your money before you get the gravy at the end that is the stock KV-1. Hope you guys enjoyed that. Hope you guys are going to go out there and drive your old JPs. Look after yourselves. Stay safe in the battlefield. Don't forget to subscribe and like the videos. And as always, stay safe in the battlefield. Bye for now. Killing it, English-wise. Look at that number. Wow. Look at that carry.